Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll show you how to work with observable collection in the Sync Fusion Blazor Kanban component. Before moving to the coding part, let me explain what observable collection is. Observable collection is a dynamic data collection that provides notifications when you add, update, and delete the items at runtime. Let's get into the code now. I'll open my existing example, where the Kanban component is configured, to show software development work in progress. If you want to learn how to create a basic Blazor WebAssembly application and add a Sync Fusion Kanban component to it, refer to the video linked in the card above or in the description below. Let me run this application. Here you can see the Kanban board rendered with software work in progress data. In this list collection, while performing add, update, or delete actions, you'll need an additional refresh call to reflect the changes at runtime. But with the observable collection support, additional refresh call is not required. Now I'll show you the steps to bind dynamic data to the Blazor Kanban component using observable collection. To use observable collection, let me first import the namespaces system.collections.objectModel and system.componentModel. Next, create a public variable, observable data, with the type observable collection of task model. Inside the uninitialized method, I assign the generated task details to this observable data variable. When using an observable collection data source, the component type will be inferred from the data value. So, I will remove the t-value property. Then I assign this observable collection to the data source property of Kanban component. Look at the output page now. The Blazor Kanban component is displayed with the dynamic collection. Now, I need three buttons to perform add, delete, and update card actions in this application. To use a button, I import the namespace syncfusion.blazor.buttons. Then I add a content division tag with some margin styles and include three buttons with the captions add card, update card, and delete card. Then I add an onClick event and assign the method addNewCard. I will declare the variable addUniqueID. In this method, generate the unique ID and add the new card details to the observable collection. In the same way, I add an onClick event for the update and delete buttons with their callback methods. I declare the variable updateUniqueID. In this updateCard method, I update the observable collection based on the generated unique ID. I change the summary to card updated and status to testing. In the deleteCard method, the first item will be removed from the observable collection. Check now when I click the add button. A new task will be generated here. This is because, when adding a new record to the observable collection, it notifies the changes using the Notify Collection Changed interface. This interface will update data without any refresh calls. The same thing happens when performing update and delete operations. Next, I will show you how to update property value using the Notify Property Changed interface. Kanban provides support to update its data without any additional refresh call when changing property value of item, if an item implements the Notify Property Changed interface. I change the model class task model to implement the interface Notify Property Changed. From the name, you can understand that it will send notifications when the property value changes. To do that, I use the Property Changed event handler, which handles the Property Changed event. Define a private method, notify property changed, and pass the name of the property that changed in the collection to this event handler. I want to trigger this event while changing the status field. So, declare another model field, status changed. Inside this status field, I will get the value and pass the property name to the notify property changed method. I'll add the debugger here. Now when I drag this task from to-do to in-progress status, breakpoint will hit on notify property changed event, where I pass the property name to the property changed event. Kanban board automatically updates its changed property values in the data object by listening to this property changed event. Now we've seen how to work with observable collection and notify property changed interface in the Sync Fusion Blazor Kanban component. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also listed a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.